I would like to appreciate the minister for bringing this bill. I understand that this entire house is together. None of us can approve of what happens to our children. None of us can accept that their entire future is taken away by people who abuse them sexually. And the minister is perfectly right that when she says that the collective consciousness of this house and the entire nation is shocked every time when we come across, read or hear about a case like that. We are all shocked. And today I could see when she was talking about the bill, she was shaken. It disturbs all of us here. So we are, and I would like to appreciate her, because in this the amendment, she has taken away the discrimination between genders. Because we generally believe that it is only the girl child who is affected, which is far from the truth. There are so many young boys who are sexually abused and they're traumatized throughout their life. I'd like to bring up an example of a father. When his daughter was born, he refused to touch her. And actually his wife was very upset, because she thought because it is a girl child, he did not want to look at the child, come next to the child. And finally, when they took him to a therapist, they found out that he was abused as a child and he could not trust his own self. He was so scared that, you know, something will be still there, some residue left in him, which, you know, he will, even by touching that child, he might pass on something, you know, which, just imagine the guilt, the pain the child has been carrying throughout his life. That, I mean, there are so many young boys. And we also believe that the offenders are always men, which is not true. So I think the minister for, you know, taking away that gender bar, which has been there, and she's also brought in pornography, child pornography is something society has to spurn and detest. But it is on the rise, and we have to be, it's on the rise, just not in India, in so many countries. And this is a very right thing which she has done. But I think along with pornography, yes, there are laws which will take care of child prostitution. I hope if there'll be another bill, or even in this bill, if she can address this. Because trafficking for prostitution, I mean, there are other acts, but then under the POCSO, there's nothing, the bill doesn't talk about child prostitution. I think that also has to be addressed, because there are so many children who are trafficked for prostitution and abused. So, with all this, I appreciate the intention of the minister, and all of us here, we more respond very emotionally when something like this takes place. Even as a mother, as a human being, when I heard of the Kathua case, where a child, we cannot believe that anybody can treat a child like that, and that too in a temple premises. You know, it was disgusting, and I think it is also a reaction to what happened, that this bill is being brought in today. That we really think and believe that the person, the perpetrator of this crime, should be drawn, hung and quartered. But can we make laws based on emotions? Laws are for the future. Laws cannot be made on what we think the criminal deserves. Laws have to be made on with a future in mind, with justice in mind, and also what is the best for the victim. We know in India that even if we say that it's on the rise, we also have to understand that most of the cases are underreported. Many of the sexual abuse cases for children are women, and especially when it comes to children, they are not reported. Because we know, many studies have revealed that majority of the offenders, National Crime Records 2016 says 94.5% of the offenders are relatives, people who are very close to the children, guardians. So most of these cases are not reported. And we know when in a family structure like India, what happens is the breadwinner is always protected. Not many cases where the family is willing to report when it is an uncle, when it is a father, when it is a grandfather or an aunt. And when it comes, when you indiscriminately increase the number of years, there is the onus on the child also. There's one more case I'd like to talk about. This child was adopted by her uncle. And they were she was brought up by that family. And after a few years, there was another child where the uncle who did not have a child had another child, a boy. But this uncle was continuously abusing this girl. So when finally she gathered the courage to report it, and when she found out that the punishment would be 20 years, she rethought and she told these activists that, who will take care of my brother? Who will take care of their son if I report? So there are many cases when we enhance punishment for the sake of punishment that the witness turns hostile. And there's so much of family pressure also. How many families will allow a relative or a breadwinner or a guardian to be sent to the for death penalty, to be hung? I think these have to be taken into consideration, because what you think you bring, we agree that it's brought with the best intention in mind, but then that should not become a deterrent for people to report the crime, for people witnesses being turned hostile. And one more thing is, there is definitely a lot of protection and sensitivity shown after the POXO bill was passed in 2012 about how a child should be questioned, how they should be protected. But then when you bring in death penalty into it, then the judge is forced to make sure that there is no ambiguity in the case. So the judge is forced to directly question the child. The child, for them, it will become another harrowing experience, being questioned, being made to go into the details of the case. So what was already abused, what is already a traumatic experience for the child, can they have to relive that again when the case is, when the judges are forced to, question the children directly. And one thing is, many cases when the punishment is, really enhanced, and especially in cases of death penalty, even when there is an iota of doubt, the judge generally acquits. So, and especially when it comes to child abuse, it is very difficult to prove it 100%, and we know of many cases, because the children do not talk immediately. And there are so many cases where you don't have witnesses. So what happens then? Then that is when the judge tends to acquit. So your intentions are right. I agree, I respect your intentions, and the entire nation believes that these people should be shown no mercy, and I'm with you on that. But just because you want to give death penalty and bring death penalty into this, it shouldn't not become a deterrent. It should not become a deterrent for a family from by stopping them from complaining, from making the judge become extra cautious and expect that the case should be foolproof. So with this in mind, I think the minister should reconsider. I'm sure she understands, by all the experiences which have been brought to her as a minister, that definitely death penalty is not the answer to every crime in this country. This government tends to believe that death penalty will deter every crime. It doesn't happen. We've seen that. And most of the nations are moving away from it. I think we should also start doing that. And the minister should send this to a standing committee or a select committee and bring the bill back And the most important thing is to make sure the child feels protected and the family supports the child to go ahead and complain, and there's justice done to the child, and not that, increasing punishment is not the answer to everything.
Thank you. Before I call the next speaker, I just like to mention certain things for the minister for your consideration. हिंदी में हम कहते हैं कि लैंगिक अपराधों से बालकों का संरक्षण संशोधन विधेयक 2019. In English, it is the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Amendment Bill 2016. अगर हम इसको जेंडर न्यूट्रल क्या हिंदी में नहीं कर सकते? बालकों, it's for your consideration. बालकों जब हम कहते हैं
of the government, and there is a understanding that it will be gender neutral even with the Hindi pronunciation that you just brought to the notice of the House.
जब हम हिंदी में नाबालिग भी कहते
हैं, not only the male female child but also the third gender is a considered opinion of the lobbyist.
Now I call Srimati Shatabdi Rai.